हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी। यू हैव आई थिंक आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी। नाउ यू हैव टू लर्न एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव। व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव, वेयर इट इज यूजफुल। फर्स्ट दैट इट इज यूजफुल for the detection of metallic or non-metallic nature. We can predict the metallic or non-metallic nature of element, nature of element. You can predict the metallic or non-metallic nature of the element. If the electronegativity of element is very high, it means their nature will be non-metallic. I mean to say, more electronegativity. More its non-metallic character. More its non-metallic nature. If the electronegativity of the element is high, it means non-metallic character is more. Fluorine is the most electronegative element, and it is halogen, and it is non-metal. All the halogens have high electronegative value in any period. When you move in a period from left to right, look here, you can see in the periodic table. First, any period starts with a alkali metal. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, and there is a halogen in the 17th group. You have to exclude the inert gas. Starting from alkali metal and ends in this halogen group number 17. I mean to say, chlorine has high electronegativity in the third period. Fluorine is the most electronegative element of the periodic table. Halogens have high electronegative elements in any period, and they are non-metal. While these are called alkali metals because they have least electronegative value. That is why more the electronegative value, more its non-metallic character. First important point, that you can predict the nature of the element. Second is, with the help of electronegativity, we can find out the polar or non-polar bonds. We can get information about the polar or non-polar bonds. Because if the electronegativity difference is zero, electronegativity of the first element A and second, that is a B, if the electronegativity difference of the two element is zero, it means it is non-polar bond, or you can say non-polar covalent bond, and homoatomic molecules are formed. In that case, homoatomic molecules is formed. If the electronegative difference between the two elements is more than zero, but less than 1.7, but less than 1.7, it means there is a polar covalent bond. This is non-polar covalent bond, this is a polar covalent bond, like the HCl, ammonia, etc. If the electronegativity difference of the elements is more than 1.7, is more than 1.7, it means electrovalent bond, yeah, you can say ionic bond, other name is ionic bond. Is formed. In that case, ionic bond is formed. Third use of the electronegative, third application, that is the acidic or basic nature of oxide. Acidic or basic nature of oxide. If the electronegativity difference is more, if electronegativity difference is more, nature of oxide will be basic oxide, like sodium oxide, potassium oxide. If the electronegativity difference of the two element is less, oxide will be, its nature will be acidic, then acidic oxide is formed. For example, sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide.